गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सो एज वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड हिस्ट्री फोर्थ चैप्टर दैट इज महाराष्ट्र बिफोर द टाइम्स ऑफ शिवाजी महाराज. सो स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर मूविंग फर्दर वील जस्ट रिवाइज वॉट वी लर्न इन अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर. सो वी लर्न दैट एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द 7th सेंचुरी most of the places of Maharashtra was under the control of Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar and Adil Shah of Bijapur. So Mughal had entered Khandesh and their main objective was to expand their power, to expand their strength in a south. So there were settlement agreement of Siddhi people who had come from Africa along with the coastline of Konkan. There the competition and the conflict between the Portuguese, British and French and Dutch who had come from Europe was during that period. The competition between Portuguese and British, French and Dutch people and the conflict were there. So the Portuguese people had already established their rule in a Goa and Vasai on the western coastline, and the other British, Dutch and French had their founding at the entry through the medium of trading companies. They are doing their business with the companies by setting up factories. This conflict had created instability and insecurity in the Maharashtra. Their conflict, these people, these foreign people's conflict had created instability and insecurity in Maharashtra. And these different people from Europe, from Portuguese, Dutch, British, French, these Europe people from Europe were called topkar on the basis of their customary headgear. So it is necessary to that get that the there is a village that is called, the another name for village is Mauja, Kasba, Pargana, to understand the settlement in that period. So generally the headquarters of Pargana was called Kasba. We'll learn more details further that the village smaller than Kasba was called Mauja. Mauja is another name for village, is called Mauja. So first is Kasba. What is Kasba? Kasba was a big village. Kasba is a big village which is usually headquarters of the Pargana. Pargana means two or more villages come under Pargana. So Kasba was like a big village. It was usually headquarters of a Pargana. Like for example, Indapur, Kasba of Indapur Pargana, Wai Kasba of Wai Pargana were the headquarters of Pargana, part of those Parganas. So in that villages, agriculture was the main occupation. And instead of agriculture, another occupations are, there were many skilled artisans are also there, like carpenters and blacksmith in a kasba, in a big village. In that big village, there were also a market was also there. The another name is pet. Market was called pet. So in that pet, in that market, the shete and mahajan were the watandars of the pet, head of the market. Who was the head of the market? Shete and Mahajan were the watandars of the pet. Every village did not necessarily have a pet. It was not necessary that every village had a pet or a market. So the Mahajan maintained the accounts of that market. The main head of the village, head of the market, who maintained the accounts? Mahajans had maintained the accounts. Understood Kasba? Then we learn about Pargana. As I told you, Pargana means many more villages together. That is called Pargana. but the number of villages was not same. If in one pargana, that is two villages were included, in another pargana three villages were included, so the number of villages were not same. For example, the Pune pargana was a big pargana. Why? Because it consisted 290 villages, and there were 64 villages in a Chakan pargana. Pune pargana was big because in Pune pargana 290 villages were involved. The Shirwal pargana was very small because it consisted only 40 villages. In pargana, Deshmukh and Deshpande were the head. We learn in a Maujja that Patil and Kulkarni, Patil was the chief of the village. What was the duty of Patil? To resolve the problem. And Kulkarni, who was help him in his work to maintain the accounts, revenue. Same here in Pargana, Deshmukh and Deshpande were the chief of the Patils in a Pargana. Deshmukh did not at the Pargana level what the Patil did at the village level. So same here, Deshpande was the chief of the Kulkarnis. He was at the Pargana level. The work of Kulkarnis at the village level. So these Vatandar officers, Deshpande and Deshmukh, these Vatandar officers were the link between the people and the government. These Vatandar officers, like Deshmukh and Deshpande, these Vatandar officers were the link between the people and the government. They passed the information from people to the government. In case of enemy, in case of natural calamities, these Vatandars represented the grievances of the people to the government. They provided necessary help to the people from government. Sometimes these officers misused their power. Sometimes what happened? These Vatandar officers were misused their power and they collect more money from people. So that collected money to the government on time. On such occasions, on that time, the people suffered harassment. Means these Vatandar officers were misused their power and the people faces harassment. Understood, students? Now let's move further. Next is the calamity of a famine. Calamity, natural calamities. So the agriculture was dependent on rainwater. As we all know, agriculture was the main occupation which was depend on rainwater. If it did not rain, agar barish nahi hogi, toh crops would fail. Agriculture would not happen, would not possible. So the prices of food grains rose. So it become difficult people to survive, to get the food grains on time or other things. If rainwater is not there, then agriculture not possible. If agriculture not possible, that people will not get the food grains. And other things. So all these things, because of all this, there was no fodder for the cattle. Also, water becomes scarce. Scarce means bahut kam. It become difficult to live in the village, people. If water is not there, if water is very important. If water is not there, so it is very difficult to survive life in a village. So it is, they forced to leave the village. And a famine was great calamity for the people. It was the natural calamity was for the people. And a great famine occurred in Maharashtra, in the year 1630 CE. When this great famine occurred in Maharashtra in 1630 century. That time what happened? People greatly distressed due to this famine. It has been described that that time very difficult situation were there. So how someone described that situation, that people were ready to sell themselves, खुद को बेचने के लिए, खाने के लिए खुद को बेचने के लिए ready थे, but there was nobody to buy them, कोई उनको खरीदने के लिए तैयार नहीं था. People were ready to sell themselves for food, for piece of bhakri, but there were nobody to buy them. There was a severe scarcity of food grains, shortage of food grains in that time, in the year 1630. Entire families were destroyed, and because of that famine, entire families were destroyed. Cattle, farm animals are died. Agriculture was devastated. The famine put an end to industries also. All financial transactions came to standstill. People had wandered to faraway regions in search of livelihood, and it was a great challenge of to bring come back from that situation and the devastated life of the people to normal life. It was very difficult to come back for the normal life. Understood, students? Next is the work of the Warkari movement. So in that time, that period, society was greatly influenced by blind beliefs and rituals. That time society or a people, society people were greatly influenced by blind beliefs and rituals. So that time people had become a fatalistic and inert. They had lost all the initiatives. They believe to anything. The condition of the common people was miserable, and in such situation, the saints of Maharashtra endured to inspire the masses to change the mentality of a people. Who came? Saints. Saints came to Maharashtra. So in Maharashtra, the tradition of saints, which began with Saint Jnaneshwar and Saint Namdev, was carried on by saints coming from various strata of the society. These saints, Saint Jnaneshwar and Saint Namdev, changed the mentality of a people for the beliefs and rituals. People from all strata of a society were part of the saint tradition. For example, Saint Chokamela, Saint Gauroba, Saint Sena, Saint Savta, Saint Narahari, Sheikh Mohammed, etc. Saint Chokaba's wife, Saint Soirabai, and sister Saint Nirmalabai, Saint Muktabai, Saint Janabai, Saint Kanopatra, Saint Bainabai Shirurkar, and other women were also with them. Pandharpur was the center of a saint movement. Dash was the center of the saint movement. Kaunsa center, main center kaunsa tha? Pandharpur. Vitthal was the object of their worship. Worship means prayer. Worship means what? Prayer. And on the banks of river Chandragaba, at Pandharpur, the saints and pilgrims means Warkari people, used to rejoice in their devotion, used to do the prayer, and their equality of propagated means to expand through bhajans, kirtans, and unity meals. The saints, what was their main motive? Their main motive was to spread the bhajans, kirtans, and unities in the people. Next is Saint Namdev. He was also a great saint of Warkari movement. He was a skilled organizer. He performed excellent kirtans well. All these saints were very good in kirtan and bhajans, but Saint Namdev was very skilled organizer and excellent kirtan. He awakened the sense of equality His main motive was all men and women are equal. All human beings are equal. Belonging to all castes through the medium of kirtans. His pledge was Nachu kirtana chirangi jnana deepa lau jagi. His abhanga compositions are well known. Many saints were as well as common people were influenced by his teachings. His teachings were based on equality. Sant Namdev's teaching was based on equality. For him, all are equal. There is no discrimination between caste, religion, sex, gender. No. So many people influenced his teachings. He went up the Punjab. For what? Why he went to Punjab? To propagate, to spread his thoughts. His compositions were included in Guru Granth Sahib of Sikh. He propagated, he spread his message of Bhagwat religion in all quarters. He built a memorial Saint Chokamela at Pandharpur, and his work was unforgettable because his main object was to spread the equality, to spread his thoughts. So he was the great saint of Warkari movement. He was great skilled organizer, excellent kirtan. His main object was to spread the equality. There is no discrimination. All men and women are equal. No discrimination between caste, creed, religion. He spread his teachings. He propagated his teachings throughout the people. His compositions were included in Guru Granth Sahib of Sikh. He propagated, he spread the message of Bhagwat religion in all the quarters, and he built a memorial of Saint Chokamela at Pandharpur, and his work is unforgettable. So students, all of you understood about Sant Namdev? Okay. Next is Sant Gnaneshwar. So all of you understood about Sant Namdev? Okay, now let's move Sant Gnaneshwar. He was also a great saint in a Warkari movement. So he wrote the Bhavartha Deepika or Gnaneshwari, which elucidates the meaning, who explain the meaning of Sanskrit, that is in a Bhagavad Gita. He was also a great saint of Warkari movement. He wrote Bhavartha Deepika or Gnaneshwari, which meaning in a Sanskrit was in a Bhagavad Gita. He was also composed Amrutanubhav. He preached the importance of the path of devotion, the way of devotion, way of God, through his work and compositions. He showed a simple way of worship, simple way of prayer, simple way of worship and conduct, which the common people were easily follow. He gave the prestige of the religion to the Warkari movement. Through his whole life, he spent the extremely adverse circumstances, situations. He never lost the calm of his mind. He used cool-minded. Never lost his calm and never harbored the bitterness. His Pasaidan in Gnaneshwari uplifts the mind, and the poetic composition of his brother Saint Nivruttinath and Saint Sopandev and Sister Muktabai were well known. So Saint Gnaneshwar was also a great saint of Warkari movement. He wrote Bhavartha Deepika or Gnaneshwari. And in his composition, Ma Amrutanubhav, he preached the importance of path of devotion, way of prayer, way of God, through his composition. His teaching was very simple and easy to follow a common people. His siblings, that brother and sister, brothers Nivruttinath and Sopandev and sister Mukta Devi Bai were also well known. So all of you understood, students, about Sant Nyaneshwar, Sant Namdev. Here short notes will ask. So what you have to write about Sant Nyaneshwar? That he was a great saint in a Warkari movement. He wrote Bhavartha Deepika or Nyaneshwari. He preached the importance of path of devotion. His teaching was very simple and easy to understand common people. His Pasaidan in Nyaneshwari uplifts the mind. The poetic composition of brothers Sant Nivruttinath Sopandev, sister Muktabai are well known. And same you have to write for Sant Namdev, that he was also a great saint in Warkari movement. He was excellent kirtans. Okay, students, all of you understood?